Jedi, and I like Sith, and both are kind of cool too, but seeing as it was ordinary people that won the war, and, you know, the Jedi and the Sith really got involved in the original trilogy, you know, for the actual fighting of the war. I loved Star Wars Empire, I loved the X-Wing series, and I'm wondering if there's anything planned for ordinary people that inhabit that galaxy that don't have special powers or were grown in a vat.
Well, yes. We've got John Ostrander and Stefan Rue are working on a new series, Agent of the Empire. And one of the dictates for that is no Jedi, no Sith, other than maybe a cameo appearance by Darth Vader. So it's all regular people dealing with political intrigue and criminal organizations and, you know, spying within the Empire. So that's certainly one thing.
The new Knight Errant storyline that starts next month features Devil Squadron, which, again, this is the storyline that actually follows the events of the novel that came out. But I guess I would say if you were to, you know, make a diehard comparison to Knight Errant, this would be Kara Holt saying, "Now I have a fighter squadron, ho, ho, ho." This is her working with some regular people who have extraordinary skills to try to fight off all the Sith that are out there.
Awesome. Thank you.
My question is for the entire panel. Do you guys have any plans for comics in the era, basically before the Tales of the Old Jedi? Or, like, say, the 100 Years of Darkness that's been mentioned in the comics over the formation of the Republic?
Well, not specifically that time period, but come October, you're going to hear about something that will, I think, leave everyone's jaw on the floor. I can't say any more than that.
Because we've got the Old Republic tie-ins.
Yes.
Thank you.
Hi. I'm a big EU fan, and I was just wondering, I know the Clone Wars is like around 5 years in EU time. I was just wondering how much more you can do with it, because I know there's like a huge amount of books and comics, and there was a previous TV series, and this series
that
I just heard,
so
5 seasons. I was just wondering how much more
you can
put in
there. Well, I guess that would really be a question for Dave Filoni, who's not here. But my stock answer when people ask me stuff like that is, it's a huge, huge galaxy. And not everything happens one after another after another. There's a lot of different events that are taking place literally at the same time. Mm-hmm. So I think there's room for a lot more if it's handled right. If every story is about the same characters, then yeah, you start running into problems. But it's a big galaxy. There are lots and lots of characters.
And as long as the books sell, the galaxy is bigger.
Can you demonstrate how big the galaxy is?
Okay, Leland is, let's say, the outer rim. Australia is, no, I don't know. No, I can't.
You can cram a lot of stories in,
yeah,
with if you work it right. I think we did 50 odd issues of Knights of the Old Republic, and it was a calendar year of St. Carrick's life, and it actually could have been less. We put in some months you didn't see. So, if you look at some of the superhero comics that are out there, these characters never get older or anything, and we never worry about how it is that they're able to fit everything in. We're actually trying to pay attention to that.
And Randy's actually, one of the things Randy's always telling me is, if you try and set something on a world that already exists, he's like, it's an entire galaxy. You know, there are more planets. Just, you know, put it on another planet, which means you need to create another planet. Which means you get a whole new race, you get more people, you get more stories, you get more comments, you get more love. Thank you.
All right, guys, so that's about all the time we have. How about a round of applause for all of our panelists here?